U.S. authorities have eased the mask guidelines for Americans when outdoors. The U.S. Centers for Disease Control and Prevention says fully vaccinated people can dine at outdoor restaurants, while others from multiple households. They can also attend small outdoor gatherings with a mixture of fully vaccinated and unvaccinated people. But the CDC recommends wearing masks when attending crowded outdoor activities like sports events and parades and visits to indoor places like malls and places of worship.
Generally, for vaccinated people, outdoor activities without a mask are safe. However, we continue to recommend masking in crowded outdoor settings and venues, such as packed stadiums and concerts, where there is decreased ability to maintain physical distance and where many unvaccinated people may also be present.
If you're vaccinated, you can do more things more safely, both outdoors as well as indoors. For those who haven't gotten their vaccination yet, especially if you're younger or think you don't need it, this is another great reason to go get vaccinated now, now. While we still have a long way to go in this fight and a lot of work to do in May and June to get us to July 4th, we've made stunning progress because of all of you, the American people.
New COVID-19 cases have dropped 16% over the past week in the U.S., where over 140 million people, nearly half of the population, have received at least one dose of a COVID-19 vaccine. That is the biggest percentage drop in weekly new cases since February, according to Reuters. Back here at home, the Philippine government is expected to announce its decision on the possible extension of the modified enhanced community quarantine in the so-called NCR plus bubble tonight. Some mayors in Metro Manila are in favor of an extension after the current restrictions expire at the end of this month to curb the surge in coronavirus infections.
Hindi po tumataas po yung aming po mga new cases, mga active cases. Pero makikita po natin, hindi rin talaga sumubaba siya ng gusto. Pero ang maganda po, nagtato po sa amin. So ibig sabihin, na hindi pa po talaga kampante po tayo dito sa Paranaque.
If you ask me, since we've gone through the pain of doing an ECQ, an MECQ, maybe another 1 to 2 weeks MECQ might help flatten it again and bring it back to levels where it was, let's say, February or January.
Now, on Tuesday, more than 7,000 new COVID-19 cases were confirmed in the Philippines, bringing the total number of active cases to over 71,000. But health officials note 22 laboratories did not submit their data. 63 new deaths and over 10,000 recoveries were also recorded. The country's COVID-19 treatment czar backs the recommendation of some Metro Manila mayors to extend the MECQ in the National Capital Region and its surrounding areas. Health Undersecretary Leopoldo Vega says the country needs to preserve whatever gains it made in the healthcare capacity first before easing those restrictions. He cites the 150 additional ICU beds that were generated in Metro Manila over the last month.
If you take a look at the number of cases, there might be a decrease and even a plateauing, but we have to make sure that we have to be ready for anything that will come. The gains that we have came in later, about the fourth or the third and the fourth and the fifth week. So it's much better that we have this kind of status right now.
The Philippine government will temporarily ban the entry of all travelers from India, which is now struggling to contain a spike in COVID-19 cases. The travel ban will take effect starting April 29th until May 14th. But presidential spokesperson Hadi Roque says passengers already in transit from India and those with recent travel history to that country will be exempted. But they're required to undergo quarantine for 14 days at a facility even if they previously tested negative for COVID-19. Roque says the transport department should make sure that airlines will not allow passengers covered by the travel ban to board flights to the country except if they're part of the Philippine government's repatriation efforts.
Yung mga restrictions po para sa mga iba pang biyahero na galing sa mga ibang bansa na meron na rin pong variant na galing po sa India ay pwede pong ma-impose ng Office of the President upon the joint recommendation po ng Department of Health at ng Department of Foreign Affairs.